Hello, darlings. Welcome to my channel. So, this is going to be my very first video about me speaking about anything that comes in my mind. I've just figured out that forgive me, I have no makeup on. The lighting is not that good because it's really light. It's actually 1 a.m. It's 1 a.m. and I was about to get on bed. I usually sleep late. It's either 1 or 2 a.m. So before I get on bed, I felt like I should speak about this. I believe there's somebody out there who need to hear whatever I'm going to say or what I'm going to talk about. Well, tonight, I would like to speak with you. Why are you running away from them? Why are you running away from love? You should ask yourself, because I have figured there are people. Which is, I'm trying to say, if you could be a child who grew up watching his or her parents fighting all the time, and one of them could be a mother or a father, has always tried to be there for the partner, I mean, the father or a mother. And the other side is actually all the time acting negative in a negative way. It could be abusive. They could be abused. Now, the parents between themselves could be fighting, arguing, fighting. So this child grew up. Him or she, I mean him or her, observing this, consuming this, seeing this all throughout his life, it kind of made him or her scared and very sensitive with love. Disappointment or unloved. So whenever this person sees somebody or feels like there's somebody who actually cares, who actually loves them, he or she will get to know. I tell you what, yourself. Don't punish yourself. It's about time to let it go. That was their lives. That was their fate. You have your own life. This beautiful thing that you wished you could have seen, that you wish you could have been around with in your life. Why don't you be that best husband to the woman who loves you? Why don't you be this best wife to a man who actually loves you? Why can't you be this best father to the kids that someday you're gonna have or you already have? You cannot keep on running away from people who loves you, from people who needs you. It's enough. It's enough. Because by doing that, you're not only hurting yourself, you're also sees something on you, sees something about you that they loved, that they wish they could have in their lives. You're hurting these people. You're not the only, you're not hurting only yourself, but also the people around you. Stop pulling away. And this does not mean only to your spouses or your partners. It goes even your siblings, your parents. Whenever you see them showing love to you, you're pulling away because you're scared to be left alone in the end. You think they're gonna get done with you and leave you. You think when you open up to them, they're gonna hurt you the same way you saw how your mother or your father went through. You're scared to go through that. Guess what? You have your own fate and you have all the power to control that. You saw all that scenario before. You went through this before. So you know how to actually do or how to actually avoid some stuff. When you're going through it, you picked up some things which you can use as your shields, your weapons, to make you go through these battles and wars that you're gonna go through. Because I'm telling you, my darling, there is no permanent joy. There is no permanent pain. And in life, we all have to go through these phases. There is a moment of happiness. You get to the point of saying, hey, God, what did I do to deserve all this? And you're gonna get to the moment and you're actually like, God, what did I do to deserve all this? Why me? So it happens to everyone. Every space. How you respond
to this pain, how you respond to this sadness, loneliness. That's when actually the illness, this virus, disease grow up in you, eats you, and it's controlling you slowly, it's killing you slowly, because you never take care of yourself at first place, because this time when you sense it, stick with them. Try to love these people back. Try to give yourself a chance. Try to forgive yourself and forgive those people who made you who you are today. A person who is terrified. Change someone, it's gonna touch somebody. So if you are the one, do not hesitate, just text me, leave me a comment, and do not forget to subscribe to my channel. I'm very new at this, and I am announced my very first video is actually but hey, I had to do this because I believe you who is watching me right now, we're supposed to watch this. Just do not forget, God loves you, and God is putting you through things, through trials, through whatever, just to prove to you that he's watching for you, he got you. So special to go through all this, because there's something in you that can bring something beautiful out of you. God makes us go through things first to do that, to be stronger. To love him even better, to go back to him. This is your moment right now to actually go closer to God, speak to him, he listens. He's there watching us. You do not really have to pray five times a day, like how fast.
pray 5 times a day. If you do not feel like it, if you're not feeling it, you know, praying is 5 times a day, and you just pray because you're supposed to pray, and you're not actually giving yourself to Him, to God, and believe like the prayers you do, it's actually you actually mean to do them. On my opinion, I think that it's not very. You speak to Him when you feel like it, and not necessarily on your knees or on your praying mat. Whatever, whenever, pray. It's not even necessarily to go through hear you. You can even sit down and speak out, scream, cry. Just imagine it's right there listening, so you can say everything, anything, because He knows even before you say anything. So it's really the way you are not brought in this world to suffer, to be unloved. Everybody in this world deserves happiness once in a while.